Okay, so a question that I get a lot is, what are some basic silversmithing tools or jewelry making tools that you need to start, like just to start practicing and learning? In case you guys don't know me, my name is Adriana and I have been running my jewelry business for the last 2 years. It's called Matera Made. I started learning with a lot of these basic tools. Getting into silversmithing is really expensive and there are a lot of tools that you can buy. So starting out, you want to make sure that you're not buying things that you don't need at first. So I put together a list of like minimal items that you need to get started. I hope that this can save you some money and make getting started a little less scary, knowing that you're not going to buy like things that won't be useful to you. So this is just going to be a beginner set of tools. I'm going to do a little video of the tools so that you can take a screenshot, because if you are short on time, I don't want to waste your time. So you can take a screenshot of what I'm showing right now so that you know what to buy. So let's get into it. So the first item that you're going to want is some flux. So I recently made a video on soldering. If you've watched that video, then you know my opinion when you're first starting to learn is to use solder paste instead of solder chips and flux. When you first start soldering, using paste is a lot easier to getting like the concept down, for me at least, but you will need flux. So this helps the solder flow, and you just pour a little bit of water into the cup. You just put it on your piece, and when you heat it up and the solder chip is on there, the flux helps it flow. Flux though, and like, I mean, anytime you heat something up, it's gonna put off chemicals that are not good to breathe. So you wanna make sure that you're soldering in a really well ventilated area and that you're wearing all of your proper gear. And I'm smiling because I know a lot of you who've been watching my videos already, my studio vlogs, you're like wagging your finger and saying, but you don't wear your mask. So I know I'm gonna be better about that. Whenever we get to our new house, a good respirator mask is on my list to buy. I did have a respirator whenever I first started. I'll put a little picture of what I'm talking about, but you wanna have a good respirator because those fumes are really bad for your lungs, and I am not the best at always wearing my mask. And yeah, so I'm just gonna like leave that there. So the next thing that you're gonna wanna buy is, of course, solder paste and a soldering pick. You're gonna need the solder pick to apply your solder paste. Some people also like to turn their solder into a ball and then use this to manipulate it. Solder paste can come in easy and medium and all of that stuff, so just get easy solder paste, that way it flows with a lower heat. Can you see this bug? Holy moly, that is a giant fly. Oh god, he's huge. That's the biggest fly I've ever seen in my life. He's doing his hands like this. Okay, you're gross, get out. The next thing on the list are some rotary tools. So these are gonna be some sanding discs. I like using these radial discs. They have a different color for each grit. These radial discs are for sanding and polishing. I use my rougher ones whenever I'm needing to sand away a scratch or whatever. Getting it to the green one, the finest grit in the pack, it does make it shiny, but you're also going to need some polishing mops and some polishing compound if you want to see your piece really shine. So I think that these are so easy to use. So after these radial discs, if you want to have a really good polish, then you're going to want to get some polishing compound. I use 2 polishing compounds. So this is, what is the name of this one again? Tripoli. You want to just get a little mop like this, and you want to have 1 mop for your Tripoli and 1 mop for your Rouge. These compounds are like gritted sandpaper, and if you mix the two, then you'll never get the best shine because you mixed both grits. After you use your green sanding wheel, you want to use your Tripoli, and then you want to wash your piece, and then use a new mop that's dedicated to Rouge, and this is what the Rouge looks like. And this gets you that really, really, really high shine. So, Tripoli and Rouge. And then for soldering, you're gonna want some soldering blocks. So I got 3, and I think they sell 3 in a pack on Amazon, but I like having 3 because sometimes I use it to create a wall to give it more heat. Sometimes I put them together and I sandwich the ring in the middle. And then you're gonna want some tweezers as well. The tweezers that you're gonna want a third hand, so this, whenever you squeeze it, it opens, and then whenever you stop squeezing it, it holds it. So obviously, it's gonna be too hot to hold. Sometimes you need the ring to be standing, so you're gonna want something that can hold it for you. I use this also whenever I'm soldering ear posts onto an earring or a ring band onto a bezel cup. And then you just want your classic tweezers so that after you solder something, you can pick it up and put it in your quench bowl. And then again, like the reverse action tweezers to have another one. When it comes to pliers, I've never had a huge array of pliers. I'm sure there are some that would have made my life easier, but these are the ones that I use the most. So I've got my flush cutters. These allow you to cut a straight line without giving you that like ridge in the middle. Some nylon pliers so that they don't dig into your metal when you use it. My half round pliers, and this helps me like form a ring if I'm working with metal that's really hard. And then just some little needle nose pliers. I use these all the time. The next thing that you're gonna want are some calipers. So whenever it comes to sizing rings and making a ring the size that you want, you have to use these. If a ring is off by a millimeter, it's gonna be a different size. So you can find these really cheap on Amazon, and all of these things, most of these things I have listed on my Amazon storefront, and I'll have that link down in the description. I do get a small commission if you use the link, but it doesn't cost you anything, so. The next thing you're gonna need is a ring mandrel and a rawhide mallet. I know some people don't like the ring mandrels that have this gap in the middle where the sizes are, but it works fine for me, and this was in a cheap little kit that had like a ring sizer set with it. But so when you're starting out, the only files you're gonna need is a cheap little set that has like a half round file, a square file, one with the little, like a triangle file, I don't know what this is called. But you just wanna get a small little set. When it comes to upgrading, like these big files are really, really, really nice. I'm so glad that I got those eventually, because those are kind of expensive, and if you're just starting and just learning, you're trying to spend the least amount of money as possible, right? So a small little file set is all you need when you first get started. You're also gonna need beeswax for your jeweler's saw, which actually I didn't have that in the picture, so hang on. So beeswax and a jeweler's saw. This also comes in a little kit on Amazon. They'll give you blades and the saw and your beeswax. This is the same blade that I used when I first started 2 years ago. And this was a cheap, like no name brand saw, and it works really, really well. There are really pricey jeweler saws out there that have a bigger frame, and I'm sure they're really nice to work with, but when you're first starting, this is all you need, and this is still what I use. Another thing that you're gonna need that I couldn't really include in the picture because it hangs up there is some kind of rotary tool. Whenever I first started, I used a Black & Decker, like super heavy and chunky drill that I got on Amazon. And then later, I bought a flex shaft attachment to go with it, but it just couldn't handle the amount of work that I was doing. So then I eventually upgraded, but I used that in the beginning and it worked really well. And I think it was like maybe $39 or $40. So you can get a cheap one, and Black & Decker makes one with a flex shaft. Dremel makes one with a flex shaft as well. I just wouldn't recommend jumping in and getting a Fordham one or any of the other like jeweler's motor pendant thingies, because they're really expensive. And like I said, when you're first starting, you want to save as much money as you can to just get the basic tools. So another thing that you're gonna want is something to pickle your jewelry. So a pickle is an acid solution that cleans your jewelry after you heat it up. And I got this little crock pot. It's super tiny. I got it at our local thrift store for like $5. So you can definitely get one that's pre-loved and use it. What I use for my pickle solution is vinegar and salt. So I do about a tablespoon. I just eyeball it, and then I use maybe like 2 cups of vinegar. I'm not super scientific about it. So I think that's everything for this list for beginners. If there's anything that I missed that someone else might suggest that someone get, please put it down in the comments. But I think all of this in the beginning is about what I had, and I was okay. If you guys have any questions, just leave them in the comments below, but I will be making a tools list again for wax carving and like materials, like metals and stuff like that. If you're wanting to purchase any of these items, I have a lot of them listed in my Amazon storefront. I hope this helped. I will see you guys next week. Bye guys.